that is actually what you could call love. But when somebody says the words, I love you, what do you feel? You feel a kind of love. Do you know where that love comes from? Any guesses? Yeah, where does metta come from? Sorry?
Yourself.
Yes. This is your own love coming up out of your own heart. Why? Because when someone says, I love you, you suddenly realize, I am lovable. Somebody loves me. I must be beautiful. And at that moment, a little bit of your own love comes up to the surface of your heart, of your life. And you feel love. That's your love for yourself. That person only triggered it, just showed it, flashed it. There isn't some magic transformation from that person to you, or transmission. Yeah, we can feel love sometimes, you know. I can't say that love is not an energy that we can't feel. Sometimes we can feel that. But maybe again, when you're feeling good vibes, you know, lovely vibes from someone else, I think this is just you connecting you to your own love. Anyway, I just want to offer that to you. You can contemplate it. See whether that's right for you or not. Everything I say tonight is just information. Take it or leave it. Do what you like with it. Check it out, see if it works for you. What happens when you say to yourself, I love myself? Can you say that to yourself? Do you love yourself?
Yes.
Great. How do those words sound in your heart? I love me. Say it. And then feel it. It's just an experiment. Just try. Maybe you don't feel anything. Maybe you feel resistance to this. If you do, you're not alone, because a lot of people feel resistance when they say this to themselves. I love myself. It's strange. And I think this is going against our own true nature. I think our own true nature is to love ourselves. Because we want to be safe, peaceful, and healthy. Somehow in society we've been taught not to love ourselves. Some teachings even say that, you know, you shouldn't love yourself, you should love others first. Put others before you. That's okay. It's nice. But what about yourself? We can't just completely overlook ourselves. I'm also a person in my life. Actually, I'm the closest person to me in my life. And I've found that when I have a natural and free love for myself, it just flows. It flows to others. It flows around. Whether they get it or not, doesn't matter. Whether there is this magic transmission from me to somebody else or not, it doesn't matter. But if I feel it, it kind of glows, it shines, it shows. Other people can see that. in this way, loving kindness just happens naturally. When you feel it within yourself, you don't want to keep it. Sometimes when people hear about the teaching of Metta and the fact that we say to ourselves, may I be safe, peaceful and healthy. May I be free from mental suffering. May I be free from physical suffering. May I take care of myself joyfully. People think this is being selfish. But it's just the beginning of the training. It's just working on your own mind. When you really open the spring, the natural spring of loving kindness in your heart, it's endless, it's limitless. When you touch that, you naturally want all beings to feel the same. It just flows. You don't want to keep this to yourself. It's so beautiful. You want to share it. And you wish all beings everywhere could feel what you feel. Such a beautiful experience. When you get that naturally, not by repeating words to yourself or trying to meditate on loving kindness, trying to work it and form it and create it and make it. But when you can do that in the beginning, that's part of it, you know, is opening up your mind to the possibility that there is endless and limitless love already in your heart. But when you finally do feel that endless surge of love, there's just this opening up to all beings and just knowing all beings also want this. All beings everywhere always have access to this love. We just cover it up with our selfish stories. We get locked into our own stories. We forget that love is unlimited, endless. It's like the internet. Metta, unconditional love, it's like the internet. It's always available. 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year. Always available. Just need the password. Need a service provider and a password. You can log on anytime you like. And you can use as much as you like. Love is like that. It's always available. You just got to tune into it. Just got to realize it's there. You can live in that if you want. It's like being permanently connected to the internet. Sounds a bit scary, actually. So, this evening I've shared three basic topics. The first was appreciation, which arises from your present moment. You can start by just checking how do I feel now. What can I appreciate here and now? One of the best things that you can appreciate in this moment is seeing. Appreciating your eyes, appreciating the fact that you can see, and hearing, celebrating these funny little flaps of skin on the side of your head, these ears, and the process of hearing, and appreciating hearing, and the fact that you can feel your body, you can feel and touch things around you. Appreciating that.